Takes us to item 7G, the Gun Club Super Sporting Clays Course. Dale, you could have motioned it to me while you were up. Just get this going, but
you brought the
A team. Good.
Yeah.
Good. Welcome. Thanks for coming, guys.
Thank you. I'm Bart Morrill, Parks Division. What am I? Assistant Director of Parks and Open Space. This is Jenny McGowan. She is our Gun Club Manager. Jenny put in for a grant and received a grant to put in a super sporting clay course up at the Gun Club. I'm going to let Jenny speak to it because she can describe it a lot better than I can. Did you want to start your video?
Sure.
Okay.
Can you shoot better than Bart too, Jenny?
Can I say yes and not sound arrogant?
Yeah, no, you can say yes.
Jenny's a world-class shooter. I'm a hope to hit.
But the super sporting clay course, but we're going to show you a quick 3-minute video that'll explain it. But when I came and spoke to you guys in the spring, the demo run that we did, that's what I put in for a grant to make it so it could be an all the time thing, and we got it. So this is a quick to show you again what it is, because sometimes if you're not familiar with shooting sports, you think, is there a gun involved? That's about all I know. So if you'll start this, and then I'll tell you something.
Pull. Hello, and welcome to this special episode of the CPSA How to Hit series, sponsored by Browning and filmed here at the beautiful E.J. Churchill Ground at West Wickham. Today's episode, I'm going to be covering the newly registered discipline of super sporting. Super sporting is governed by the same rules which cover English sporting. However, there's some major differences. The first one, there'll be a minimum of 3 traps, lettered A, B, C, etc. Targets can consist of singles, following pairs, on-report pairs, and simultaneous pairs. But there must be a minimum of 20% single targets in the menu. Like Sport Trap and Fitass, the shooter will shoot the entire menu in one go before rotating round to the next shooter. The beauty of super sporting is the repetition isn't there. You have completely different targets, the singles, the on-report, and the sims. So it's up to you to know which order they come in, and then the sim pairs, which order to shoot them in. Let me introduce you to the squad who are shooting today. We've got Phil Easman, Josh Bridges, Amy Easman, and Ian Parker. I'm ably assisted by Neil, the referee. Here we have a typical super sporting menu. As you can see, it consists of 3 singles, 2 on report, and 1 simultaneous pair. As you can see on the single targets, it's describing what target's coming. And as per normal, you're allowed full use of the gun on the singles, i.e. that is 2 shots at each target. When the first shooter gets in the stand, the referee will show 1 of each of the single targets only. The rest, as you can see from the random nature of the pairs, is up to the shooter to remember where they come from and which order to shoot them in.
I think it's good. I think it's something different, something a little bit different from normal sporting. It jazzes it up a bit, I think.
Variety, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely.
Because it makes you think a bit more.
Yeah. So you're thinking more, right, I've got singles, then my pairs, and then maybe sim pair, or gives you a bit of a variety. So the video you watched, that probably was a lot of like Spanish, or if you don't know Spanish, a language you don't know, right? I'll kind of explain. The reason I wanted you to see this, can you see that she's standing in a stand? Sporting clays, you stand in a stand. You don't stand on a normal trap field. If you've been to the gun club, you'll see a house, cement, everything's very formula, it's very structured. Sporting clay is completely different. You can build it any way you want in any space you want. The stands like that we already have from when we did our trial run. That was donated to us last time. But you can build to your area. And as you can see, targets are straight up. They roll in front of you that resemble a rabbit. There is no rhyme or reason per se.
like you would a trap. Trap is a straight away from you, same angle. Sporting clay resembles shooting birds, rabbits, ducks, things like that come into you. In the world of shotgun shooting, this is actually shot the most. So for example, at a state shoot in Spanish Fork, we hold trap, it's huge, but we'll have 200-ish people come. The shoots, the sporting clay that people attend in Utah, there's called a thing called a Browning Six Club shoot. They have over 600 people come during a week to shoot it. It's much more desirable because think of how many people shoot. If you are a shooter, if you go hunting, it's kind of more fun sometimes.
A lot more fun.
Exactly. Good job, Chad. It's a lot more fun shooting this. And I'm a trap shooter, and I've shot a lot of trap. But this is a whole different ball game. This is a riot. And it's becoming the fastest growing shotgun sport across the nation. And this super sporting, so there's sporting clays that uses two machines per stand. And then there's super sporting that uses three. What we got our grant for is super sporting. And you can do super sorting on a smaller area. And you can do seven stations. Sporting clay, you need 12 stations and you need a lot more area. So that's the reason we're doing the super sporting. And the only other super sporting clay course in the entire state is in Purgatory, down by St. George. That's the only other place that has it, and there's only one in Utah.
We're right at the sports park.
What?
We're out at the gun club.
So if you're...
Wow. Sorry, Dale, get your word there.
Next to the recreation center. We don't utilize traps 1 through 4 except for large shoots. Okay. So we place it on the traps 1 through 4. Shooting hours would be when we're open for trap shooting. We've been a trap club forever since the club was started. We don't intend to not do trap. That's our first and foremost objective, is continuing to be a world-class trap shooting facility, which we're known throughout the country for. But this will be an addition. Like I say, it's honestly a different group that usually likes to shoot this. It's something a little more fun. You don't know which direction the targets are coming from until you're seeing them right there. And so it gives you a chance to, it's just a different way of shooting. If you've ever shot sporting clays, it's similar to that. Yeah. A lot of fun. So we're looking at it as an opportunity to offer a little bit more that'll bring in a little more revenue. The gun club.
If this is helpful on the revenue side, you make double the profit in a round of sporting clay compared to trap. So if you did 50 trap targets, double the amount of revenue or profit, you could say, the profit on sporting clays, because it's kind of the people who shoot it know it's takes more targets, it takes more specialty targets, so they're smaller, some are harder, so they can roll across the ground, and there takes three machines. So people are willing to pay more to shoot it. And because we got the grant to pay for the machines, that helps us significantly. So the profit goes straight to us.
Cool.
Awesome.
Timeline.
So this is different than trap. If we were to build trap, it would take quite a while because you have to build fields, build the house. The example shoot that we did, we rented him. I had put it in a couple months in advance. He came down in a day. We set the course in a day and we shot the next day. So if you guys say yes, or whoever says yes, we could start a shoot as early as the 1st of October.
Wow. And you'll advertise those shoots the same way you do your trap shoots?
Yes and no. Because it's a completely different group of people, trap is one group, and sporting clay shooters are another. You use shotguns, yes, but they're different shotguns. It's different people. The group that in Utah, NSCA, I've already worked with them. They've given us the first Saturday of every month where no one else throws a sporting clay shoot that we can throw every month. It'll be a fun shoot where it's about 100 people will come that Saturday. Also, I kind of mentioned the Browning Six Club shoot. That's where the 600 people come to. There's six gun clubs in Utah that get to participate. And last year, one of them fell off because the gentleman is now closing his range because he's getting too old to set it anymore. So there's an opening. And they said, if we can have shoots this fall into the winter and prove that the shooters like the course and we can throw targets successfully, we will get that sixth spot, which would be a significant shoot, would be a huge profit builder for us, profit maker. So,
fun.
Any other questions?
Jenny, I love your passion at the gun club.
I love it too.
It's awesome.
Yeah, good work.
Let me speak to the budget on this that Jenny and Dale, or Bart, have put together. First of all, Jenny, when she says she went out and got the grant, she's not kidding. It's already here. She went out and hustled the money, got the approval for the grant funds, and literally the check has been deposited. So it was deposited before.
So if we say no, that looks bad.
We can just send it back.
Okay.
Yeah.
They also said they'll give me another one next year to build whatever else I want to.
Wow.
So
wow.
They said for the next probably 3 years they'll give us money. If we need like a shop to put targets or we want to invest in whatever they said.
Great.
They will keep giving money.
So I'm really impressed and pleased with the work that Jenny's done. We gave her a challenge, if you recall, 6 months or so ago to do some things to enhance the gun club and the operations and revenues especially. And we, and maybe most specifically, I have been very leery about adding additional expenses because we just aren't seeing the revenue. So to her credit, she went out and received this grant that the initial grant alone will pay for 2/3 of the construction of this and the parts and pieces for it, but then is also working on receiving some donations and sponsorships from others. So in terms of the budget, with all of the additional expenses that will come associated with building it, as well as the traps, not the traps, what we throw,
the clays
and whatnot that we throw, the labor and whatnot, we'll increase the expense side of the budget about $130,000 with this. That includes the construction, right? That's alone $85,000. But we're estimating that we'll increase the revenue by about $160,000 to offset and put a little bit more toward the bottom line of the gun club. So they've done a really good job of putting the plan together, and they believe that these are conservative numbers on the revenue side, but even if they're off, we've got a pretty good cushion there in the operational profit margin there to go toward the club that really has needed a shot in the arm, pun was intended. Mm-hmm. We aren't inviting Dick Cheney up there, but
yeah. Sure.
Anyways, great work, Jenny. I'm very pleased with what you've been doing there.
Yeah, I think this is awesome, and it also we've proven for years that the trap shooting works, right? That revenue happens, and giving it a little bit of a different spin or a different group of people to come in and experience that, I think will only help the gun club from both sides. Because some of those people do transfer over, even though they shoot different clay. You hear them talk about it, right? They like to be multifaceted, so I think this is a great opportunity. So good job.
Thank you.
Any other questions for Bart or Jenny?
I know she's going to go sit down, but I know I saw you post on Facebook that there's a date night coming up.
Yeah.
Will you just like put a plug in for that? Because that
Sure.
sounds really cool.
Sure. So we started our first date night. We had our first one a few months ago just to see how it would go. And actually, it was a different crowd than I was expecting. Most Spanish Fork citizens came, people who had never shot before. I was expecting it was
wow.
the guys that come up every week, finally get to meet their wives, and that's not what happened. But so it was a resounding success, and people want it again. So we'll have it 3 to 4 times a year, and you'll always see it come out in the city bill, your newsletter, so you know when it's coming. But imagine fancy dinner and learning how to shoot, and we will do a small competition for those who know how to shoot. But those who aren't comfortable, we do lessons during that date night.
And this is on September 23rd, correct?
Yes, at 5:00.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Even you can shoot, Shane.
I can shoot, man.
I could outshoot you.
Challenge accepted? Is that what that was?
Let's go.
Let's go.
And the husband and wife scores go together.
Well,
and
she can't shoot.
She's
not shooting.
Yeah. Maybe she'll help you, Shane.
I don't see her up there. She'll eat the dinner.
Date night, I feel like there should be a special waiver. Make sure the dates like each other. I mean, we're putting
what are you saying?
Your wife might not like you that night, and it might.
She's not coming to shoot guns.
Okay, so moving on.
But
thank you for sharing that.
These guys.
I think that sounds really fun.
Jenny, great work.
Can we
thank
put
you
on
so
a
much.
City council tournament then?
Sure. I would do it in a heartbeat.
Okay,
right.
We're in.
So we're going to donate whatever. Who are the loser has to donate their entire monthly.
Brian's nodding that SSCN is going to be there.
And you're in?
Yeah.
Okay. Then I'm in. Easy.
Monthly city council check.
To the Shane's shooting.
I love it.
Shane's wagering on
No, we're just giving back to the community.
All right, moving on.
Down the road.
No, wait a sec.
Thank you, Jenny.
I have him on the hook.
I would entertain a motion on item 7G.
I move to approve the Gun Club Super Sporting Clays course.
Second. Motion made by Councilman Euler, seconded by Councilman Argyle. Roll call vote. Councilman Marshall?
Yes.
Councilman Cardon?
Yes.
Councilman Euler?
Yes.
Councilman Argyle?
Yes.
And Councilwoman Beck?
Yes.
Item 7G is approved. Thank you, Jenny. Appreciate that.